stay around and see the light there, how it's cleaned up. Paper tape moving at about 30 miles an hour. I don't know if it's technical, but what I am told, in the middle of that tape there's some little tiny drive holes, and each hole is a tenth of a second apart, and the machine is driven by the speed of the tape. So the faster the tape goes, the faster the machine goes. That message tape is 5,000 characters long, and every time you hear that clunk behind me, it's read those 5,000 characters. So it's running at 5,000 characters a second. This machine works in parallel, not in series like modern computers, and it is very, very, very fast. In fact, the rebuild team here tell me this is as fast as the modern Pentium 2 computer. If you think this machine's over 70 years old, how much the electronics have advanced in that time, it shows you how powerful the Colossus actually was. It has switch programming, not stored, so you can switch to the switching array here to program the machine to do a one specific task. Find the message settings on the Lorenz wheel. And what it does is each time it finds a setting, it types it or it prints it out on here on this printer. And when you've got 12 settings, you can take them to the tummy machine next door, plug it up, and away you go. You can read out all Hitler's messages you've generated. Tommy Flowers is a very clever engineer because this machine was actually built out of standard post office telephone exchange parts of the day, which meant when the rebuild team started to rebuild in the middle of the 1990s, obviously it's now BT with privatisation, BT are ripping out all of their analogue telephone exchanges and going digital. The rebuild team turned up with a car and a trailer on and said to the guys, instead of throwing all of that old equipment in the skip, please throw it in our trailer. And then they have enough equipment to start a rebuild. The rebuild was online and it was originally opened, we're very lucky, by Tommy Flowers, who died about 4 years after the course of Mark on the rebuild was done. Later on, the rebuild team upgraded this machine to the Colossus Mark II, which had 2,500 valves, and it was a much more faster machine and was used later on in the war from about 1944 onwards. The reason for Colossus is very simple. The D-Day invasions in Normandy would not have been undertaken by the Allies until they knew that Adolf Hitler swallowed the rows that the Axis landings were going to take place on the Pas-de-Calais. And the way they did that was by reading Adolf Hitler's messages to his generals running each of the different parts of Europe. Therefore, I say to you, was it a coincidence that Erwin Rommel was visiting his wife for her birthday on authorised leave from Adolf Hitler when the D-Day invasion took place in Normandy? Or did he have to ask permission of his boss, Mr. Adolf Hitler, using his Lorenz system, and did we read that information? Very, very coincidental, isn't it? So Colossus really told the Allies that the Germans had actually swallowed the rows, that the landings were going to be in the Pas-de-Calais, and the D-Day invasion took place. All these machines, Colossi Mark 1, were built at Dollis Hill. Colossi Mark 2, which had to be up and running before the 4th of June 1944, was actually very, very strangely built on site. And the record show was up and running by the 3rd of June 1944. The Colossus Mark II had more valves, could do more of the finding of the settings much more quickly. I'm told that this machine uses highly advanced Bohmian mathematics to work out the message settings working backwards from the females. One thing that Tommy Flowers knew though, if you look after valves, they are very, very efficient and very, very reliable bits of kit. In fact, that black valve on the left-hand side there is an original World War II valve that's in the machine and it's still doing what it was designed to do some 60-odd years later on. Obviously, when they were rebuilding this machine, they put out a request for people to send in old valves from all over the world. So that is Colossus. If anybody's got any technical questions, please don't ask me. There's a little guy around here somewhere, there he is, that man there, Phil. He's part of the rebuild team, and if anybody's got any real detailed technical questions, I'm sure Phil would be really happy to answer them for you.